Hello everyone, Treeks here. Welcome to the final part of Super Mario Advance. Even though we technically already cleared everything, however, we only cleared everything in Super Mario 2, or at least what this game calls Super Mario 2. Remember from the very first part, there's this other thing, Mario Bros, the remake of Mario Bros. Yeah, that's also a thing. It's a thing in all of the Super Mario Advance games. For some reason they considered putting a remake of Mario Bros. On all of these. They're the same in every single one, so I'm only going to cover it once for that reason. I don't like repeats. Speaking of repeats, this is a remake of Mario Bros., like I said. Still don't consider it a repeat because this game is remade. It is a little bit different. Newer graphics and everything. I will not be 100% clearing this game though, I will just be showing it off once. I don't really think it's worth completely clearing, because that is way too repetitive. All of these levels, just like in the original one, repeat one after another. You technically clear it 100% if you go all the way up to level 99. Phase is what it's called, phase 99. Well, that's not worth it. I'll just be making one around 20 minutes video of it, at least that's what I'm aiming to do. And try to show off all of the differences, even though they're not that great. First things first, rules of this. As you can see, we have pipes on the top and bottom part of the screen, and enemies come out of those pipes. And your goal is to defeat all of the enemies. It's that easy. However, you cannot touch them or jump on top of them like in any normal Mario game. You actually have to hit the ground they're walking on. And once you do, then you can knock them over, and only then can you touch them in order to clear them off the stage. Exactly the same as the original Mario Bros. The farther you get, the more enemies you get, the more aggressive the enemies become. We start off easy with these spike enemies. You can't really call them the shell creepers or shell shockers, what they're called in the original. The ones who look like the Koopa Troopas but are not Koopa Troopas. I think they wanted to make it more clear that you cannot kill them by jumping on top of them. Therefore they replaced them with a spiky shell enemy. Therefore the spinies are now a thing. Right, every fourth stage is a bonus stage. All you have to do is collect all the coins before time runs out. And once you do, get the maximum number of points in the bonus. Other than that, the game will just simply continue with phases, making them harder, giving you harder enemies. Like in this case, the sidesteppers. We've seen one of these in the Mario 2 playthrough. Actually, a sidestepper was a normal sidestepper became Clawgrip, the boss of World 5 in Super Mario Bros. 2. Right, like I mentioned, this is a remake, and therefore it has been rehashed in such a way that it plays a lot better than the original Mario Bros. The original Mario Bros. Is a clear case of arcade game platforming, where the controls are really wonky, it's really hard to move around. Like you may have seen in my project, my one video project of the original Mario Bros. The controls in this game are way more modern. You can see that Nintendo has learned how to program its controls. This feels way more smooth and is therefore a lot easier. I don't foresee myself game overing for this reason, and therefore have decided to just call it quits when I'm at around 20 minutes, because as you may see, up to this point all of the phases become a little bit different, but that will stop at some point. At some point it'll stop renewing itself, and you just be playing through the same phase over and over again with at most more enemies or just faster enemies, but no real differences in the levels. In the original version, it went up to 11. Whenever you came up to phase 11, everything started looping around again until you game over. Right, now we get enemies which actually can jump, therefore making it harder to hit the floor underneath them and hitting them. And there's of course the POW blocks, which we know from the original. However, one difference is that there's now two locations of POW blocks, as you can see. That one that was all the way at the top wasn't there in the original version. And don't forget about the ghosts, of course, who try to force you off the platform you're standing on by spawning on the platform you're standing on. They come in two ways, the green ones and the red ones. The green ones spawn randomly on whatever platform you're standing on, and there's the red ones, which will spawn when the game decides that you're standing on the platform for too long, and therefore forces you off. Both of them kill you in one hit, of course. Everything kills you in one hit. Anyway, to return to the POW blocks. The POW blocks can, just like the beginning, be used to knock over all enemies which are currently touching the floor. And they can be used 3 times. Whenever you hit a POW block, it becomes a little bit smaller. Hit it again and it becomes really small, but is still there. And once a third time is hit, it is gone for good. So use them wisely, they will not return. And you can always, of course, go down a floor when you think it's getting a little bit too crowded, I'm gonna get hit. Just move downward, which is of course no longer possible if you are already at the bottom floor. Right? Eventually things get more chaotic. Now we get introduced to the Freezies, as you can see. Those are not enemies that are required to kill, you can always just leave them alone. However, it is not recommended to leave them alone, because if you leave them alone for too long and they end in the middle of a platform, they will freeze that platform, giving it ice physics. We all love ice physics. Right, the sidesteppers need to be hit twice, I don't think I mentioned that. First time you hit them, they become more aggressive, and the second time you hit them, then they will be knocked over. You can grab the coins for some quick extra points. No real need for them. There's no requirement to collect coins. Collecting them just gives you more points. Right, kill the Freezy before it freezes the platform. Oh yeah, this is what the pipes on the bottom part of the stage do. Whenever an enemy is at the bottom of the stage and is therefore done with falling down, it'll enter one of these pipes on the bottom floor and it'll respawn at the top one. It's not like it disappears and a new one comes. No, it's the same enemy that respawns at the pipe at the top. Right. Couldn't quite get that enemy. One thing of note is whenever an enemy is... Dang it. Didn't want to hit you. That was of course not the intention. Yeah, you see it happen right now. I was about to mention, whenever an enemy is knocked over, but not kicked off in time, it will get back up again. And it'll be more aggressive. It'll get a new color and everything. Not quite the same as you see here. Every final enemy you get always becomes more aggressive. But it can also happen whenever an enemy is knocked over, but not kicked out. It'll come back up and will be faster. That's what I mean with be more aggressive. Right, we're at phase 13 now. I believe we're already at the point where the level starts looping around and dang it. It was a mean spawn for that Freezy. I was on my way to kill the enemy I knocked over. This Freezy comes out. Yeah, you need to be a little cautious whenever you try to knock something off the top platform, because you may never know what may come out of the pipes. Not always coins when all enemies have appeared. It's probably also a reason why they incorporated the Freezies, because they are enemies that are not required to kill and can therefore infinitely spawn as long as normal enemies are still around. don't have to think that whenever you have all of the enemies on screen, and therefore think, oh, I'm safe. Nothing can spawn from the from the pipes, that's not true. There's also a possibility of freezes coming out. Well, we've seen all the enemies at this point, we've seen all of the mechanics it uses. We've seen the life system, I've died twice now. You get 5 lives in this version, as you can see. You just keep on playing until all of them are gone. That even includes whenever you are going for 100%, or the quote-unquote 100%. I don't really believe this game mode to actually have 100%, but what I mean to say is that whenever... Yeah, I couldn't outrun him. Should have gone to the left. Whenever you reach the quote-unquote end point, is phase 99, that does not mean that whenever you clear 99, you're done. That you are... that the game will say, congratulations, you completed Mario Bros. No, it'll still continue after 99. It'll just keep calling it 99. Clear phase 99, and the next phase, the 100th phase, what should be the 100th phase, will still be called 99, and it'll keep looping infinitely that way. But I believe it'll start looping long before that, because I believe we're in a loop already. Because we haven't seen anything get renewed up to this point already. Well, I was saying I was not going to game over in this version because it's a lot easier because the controls are better, but I'm not really keeping myself to that, am I? I'm dying a lot. Not really a bad thing. I never really had the intention of going to phase 99 in this version. That's not really worth it. It's too much of the same at some point. Game is already not being is already done with giving us new stuff. The background hasn't changed anymore. We get the same number of enemies. We get the same enemies in general. So every once in a while, you get this is new. Apparently, we're still not done yet when it comes to new content. Whenever you reach the bonus level at some point, the platforms become invisible. As you can see. Not that it really matters, because all of these platforms I have memorized, of course. All of the stage layouts are always the same. No matter how many faces the game throws at you, the platform layout never changes. One thing that does change, like I said, we're apparently not done yet with new stuff. Up to this point, we get introduced to icicles. The icicles that drop from the stage. You may see that the background has been frozen for a while, and now the top platform is permanently frozen as well. And randomly, icicles will start forming. And when you hit them, of course, you're dead. There's another obstacle you need to pay attention to. Ooh. Close one. One other thing this game may give you when you're trying to look for 100%, or at least the file select screen showing something, that is that whenever you reach 200,000 points in this mode, a little bit too crowded here, I'm not liking it. Whenever you hit 200,000 points and make that your high score, the file select screen will show you a Mario head icon, indicating you've reached 200,000 points. You can get up to 5 of these. So you can get up to 1 million points, which I believe is also the maximum number of points you can get in this game. But whenever you get 1 million points, and therefore 5... Whenever you get 1 million points, therefore the maximum number of points, you get 5 Mario heads. 200,000 times 5, 5 Mario head icons for each 200,000 points you get. There are two things you can say you should do if you're going to say, I want to clear this mode, I want 100% on this mode. I still don't believe it truly has it. I consider this a bonus part of the game, because the Super Mario Bros. 2 portion is what it is truly about. This is just a bonus part of this game, I believe. Therefore, never thought it was truly worth it to 100% it. But if you still want to consider doing it, and the things you need to pay attention to for doing it is reaching phase 99. Phase 99 is the highest phase you can get to. And go for 1 million points in your high score, because you can get up to 5 Mario head icons in your save file, indicating you've reached 1 million points. Those are the maximum number of things you can get. Go for maximum number of points, or go for maximum number of phases. Both of which I consider are not really worth it, so... But that's just me. I'm the one playing the game here. I'm just pointing out you do not have to play it like this. If you do want to go for clearing this, go right ahead. I just never thought it was really necessary. Not even in the original, where it was its own game. It's just an extra thing in this game. But I do want to show it off. It is, as you may have noticed, considerably different than its original, even though it is for the most part the same. And it's not even the only remake of this game, technically, because there was in Super Mario Bros. 3, when that first came out, there was also a new iteration of Mario Bros. In that, but I believe it's only multiplayer in that. You can, of course, also play it here as multiplayer. But it's not really something I'm going to do. This is not a multiplayer channel, like I mentioned before. I'm never going to show off multiplayer stuff whenever it's only for human players. Whenever you can do multiplayer things with computer players, like Mario Kart or Mario Party or Super Smash Bros. And everything, not a problem. But I'm not going to do multiplayer stuff with just myself. It's going to be weird. Having two controllers beside me, having to switch around and everything, that doesn't work. But in this case, there is a single player mode, unlike the Super Mario Bros. 3. I will point it out when I come to that point. This obviously does not apply to the Super Mario Advance 4 version of... Oh, dang it. I thought I was standing still, but apparently I was still having a little bit of momentum. I didn't want to go out of my platform yet. Come on, go away. I want room here. Might as well show off the POW blocks. No, that I've thought of having done everything by now. As you see, everything that's currently touching the ground, whenever you hit a POW block, will start... Yeah, will behave as if being knocked over by you. So it doesn't just knock over enemies, it also puts enemies who are knocked over back up again, the same way Mario can do that. Because if this enemy is down now, but if I go down and hit it again from the platform underneath it, it'll get back up again. This is also something that's... All of these things are also in the original. The biggest difference is mostly, as you may have seen, the new location of the POW block, which wasn't there in the original version. The backgrounds and everything, the graphics are of course new, and most notably, the biggest difference, the controls. That's definitely the biggest plus side of this version of the game. The controls are way better than they are in the original. The original's really finicky. You may have seen it if you've seen me play the original. Really, really hard to keep your characters moving around. This game, it feels a lot more like any normal Mario platformer we know nowadays. Oh, there's also a thing. Good thing that still happened right before the end. Whenever you hit multiple enemies at the same time, that is a combo technically, meaning to say hit one enemy right after you've hit another one, the points are doubled. You can combo this up to multiple times. So a normal enemy hit, as you may see, is 800 points. If you can get two enemies right next to each other and take them both out technically at the same time, or almost at the same time, that second enemy will become 1600 points and the third enemy will become 3200 points. You can combo your points. It's really hard to do, and ouch! Right. I already had one life, but apparently I gained a life at some point. Not really sure how that works. I don't think you can get lives with your point score. I'm not really sure. It might be the case that whenever you get a certain number of points, it'll automatically give you a 1-up at some point. But I'm not really sure how that works. I didn't see the game give me a 1-up, so... Well, anyway, I've reached 200,000 points. I tried to jump up there to avoid the fireball, but apparently I jumped right into it. Right, up to this point, I believe the game will just loop around. We haven't seen any new things in a very long while, and I believe this continues on. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't believe it to be the case. Even if it is, I don't really think it's worth it. I'm pretty sure we've seen everything that Mario Bros. Gives us. Every mechanic in Mario Bros. Has shown up by now, up to the icicle showing up. I believe that's the final one. And you may see you get credits even if you game over, you can still continue from that point. I believe it will reset your point count, but you can still continue. Try to get up to level 99, phase 99, what it's officially called. And make it a challenge for yourself to get there without game overing, but not me, that's not my thing. So I'm just gonna call it quits now. We've seen how it works. This is, the remake of Mario Bros. You can always continue up to wherever you left off. I believe this game does save your progress, so... But with that, I think this is it for this project. Super Mario Advance is done. In the third week, we have completed Super Mario Bros. 2. Choose the game. In multiple parts. And I've shown off Mario Bros. Not really completed it, but I'm not going to complete it. I don't think it's worth it. Whenever I 100% this game, I consider this to be the 100%. The Super Mario 2 playthrough. That's what this game is. Even though it shows it as, hey, this game is equal to this game, but I don't really believe so. This I consider just bonus content. That's why I put it in the bonus videos, and I'm not 100%ing it. But if you want to, go right ahead. This is what it is. It is a part of Super Mario Advance, Super Mario Advance 2, and Super Mario Advance 3, and even Super Mario Advance 4. It's in all of them. Don't know why. Could have just put it just in this one. It would have been fine, but every other Super Mario Advance has this as well. But I will not be covering it there. Just showing it off in this version is more than enough for me. You've seen it. I don't like repeats. I just don't consider showing it off once a repeat, because you may have seen it is not exactly the same as the original version was. It is mostly the same, but not exactly the same. So showing it off in one video is more than enough. Right, with that, I'm going to close off. Super Mario Advance is with this fully complete. I will return next week after my Mario Party shenanigans with my new week project. And yes, it is time. We're going to start with a series I have already done one game of. However, that was not the first game in that series. I'm going to correct that next week. The Legend of Zelda. Tricks out.